Well, hello there. I am Zlata Brouwer from violinlounge.com. And I'm a violinist and violin teacher and matchmaker in bowed instruments. This video is about buying or renting a bowed instrument that fits your needs. And on the internet, you see lots of violins, violas and cellos. And you would think that it's not so difficult to find the right one, but it is. Because lots of instruments in the market, and it's very strange, and it's also very disappointing for people who buy the wrong instrument, is that most of them are unplayable, or unpayable, or both. And so there are just a little instruments that can really fit your needs. And that's not only for professional players, and not only for advanced players, but it especially for beginning players, it's very important to have a good instrument. And why? Compare it to learning to ride a bike. If you have maybe a kid, or maybe you remember of yourself, when they learn to ride the bike, it's maybe not so important that they have a bike with which they could win the Tour de France. But it is important that the saddle won't come off, that if they turn the steering to the left, the bike goes to the left, and to the right, it goes to the right, that accessories don't fall off, that the tires stay on, and that they are good. Otherwise, you could fall and hurt yourself. Well, with a bad instrument, you could hurt yourself too, maybe on other levels, but also on the physical level. So I'm going to give you 6 essentials that are really needed if you want to start out with a bowed instrument. Because a bad instrument is unplayable and really demotivates you. And if you're a beginner, you think, oh, that's just me, I don't have talent, I can't do this. So you throw it away and your musical dream is shattered. So I don't want that. I really want you to have a good instrument so you can have fun making music. Whatever style you play, whatever level you play. So here come the 6 tips. I've bought a very cheap unplayable instrument on the internet for around 40 euros, so you don't have to. So I'm going to tell you exactly, compare it to a student instrument that I have in my shop, and show to you what's the difference and how you can select an ideal instrument for yourself so you can make all your musical dreams come true. So here they go. I really want to show you how you can recognize the essentials of a good violin yourself. And the same goes for a viola and the cello. So for the occasion, I've bought this violin. It cost 39 euros and 95 cents, including VAT, including a bow, and a rosin, and a case. The shoulder rest, that's just mine, that's not included. So I'm going to compare it to one of my own violins. It's a student violin. It's made in Czech Republic, really from violin builders, all handmade, with a nice case, with a bow. This is a violin that costs in total 499 euros, and you can rent this for 15 euros a month. So if you want to just try out playing violin, you can rent it for 15 euros, and after some months, if you don't like it, you can just bring it back. And if you do like it, you can have of this an instrument that you can play on for years, because it has a very nice sound, and so it's really something for the future, really an investment. And this one will either demotivate you so that you don't want to touch a violin ever again in your life, or when you continue playing, you will throw it away in a week because you can't really play on it. And I'm going to explain you why. So you don't buy something that you would like to throw in the fire. It may be nice and warm, but you want an instrument that you can play on for years and that really motivates you to keep playing, and that really gives you a satisfaction, because it motivates you in a way that you know, violin playing takes a very long time to learn, and it takes a lot of effort. So when you do something good, at least, then you want it to sound good, and you don't want something to punish you all the time.